This is about the Akhandakara Vritti. Any questions? This one you have to.
Samiji, one question.
Yes.
Samiji, I can't see the video.
I am not visible.
Samiji, one thing I wanted to ask. When the mind expands in bliss, in stillness, how to search for the content? Who will search for the content when it expands?
Mind remains almost merged in the intellect when we see the inner stillness. Intellect, now even in this stage, the ego, the intellect and the mind are together as antaranga, the inner organ, antaranga. Now, in this, ego is there yet.
When it gets dipped in the bliss and it wants to get expand in stillness, who will search for the content?
Because the ego is associated with mind and buddhi. Mind is almost one with the intellect, buddhi. Buddhi is independent. The experiencer is ego associated with mind. Ego is associated with the intellect, is the searcher. Intellect and ego together search for a thing. Intellect and ego and mind together always enjoy. Mind must be there, a part which is a enjoyer. Kartatva and bhoktratva. Bhoktratva is always there in the mind. So this is a combination of, yet we have just entered the inner layer, actually when we breathe, do the breathing, watch your breath. Now we are taking breath inside, leaving outside. There is a fraction of gap between the intake and outtake. Yet in that gap we will enter actually, when we enter in the inner silence, through that gap we enter. In that, our mind, intellect and all the three are there. Some people who are emotional by nature will carry the heart also. But the enjoyer is mind, searcher is intellect, but both are associated with the same ego. Ego can participate together as the...
But there is surrender.
Surrender.
Because here it is a surrendered ego, Swamiji.
Yes, 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 yes.
Wants to become one with the absolute.
Yes, yes.
And there he experiences the bliss and stillness.
Yes, yes.
Then again to ego to bring back the ego to search for the content.
No, it is. All the three are working together. Intellect is also, it is penetrating and going, simultaneously is experiencing, just like you are driving a vehicle and experiencing a cool breeze.
But then heart alone remains in the end, no, Swamiji. Heart alone remains in the end as a surrendered.
Yes.
I have to get it back again to search for the content.
Ego can, intellect and ego and sense of mind stuff. Can do multitask at a time, which other senses cannot do. I cannot do two works at a time, but mind can work together in two fields. Multitasking is possible for it can enjoy, it can see also. When I'm seeing something and enjoying, I'm seeing also, enjoying also.
But how to surrender ego, how to get it back, the mind, intellect again, Swami?
Surrender?
It doesn't want intellect. It just wants to remain surrender at the feet of the Lord or...
This path, the Lord...
Dahara.
In Dahara Vidya, we don't usually bring into... In Bhakti school, we bring form into picture.
But here...
Form and saguna sakara we don't bring into picture. We are going by the atmic concept.
Yes, but whether it is saguna or nirguna, Swamiji, is the one who gets surrendered.
Yes.
So if I go with a surrendered heart, and if I experience the bliss, stillness, happiness, and I want to get lost in that, should I bring back the ego again to search for the content?
Yes, yes, yes. Otherwise, it will become rasa svadana. That's why the japa is not given up. The japa is not given up only because it protects from the 9 obstructions to the path of yoga. Rasa svadana is bheda, breaks through the rasa svadana is japa. Tad japa tadartha bhavana, after that, immediately the 9 obstacles, one of the obstacles is avirati, and all that is rasasvadana. Rasasvadana is broken only by japa. Japa comes almost till the end, it goes. A strong will, longing to go everywhere, the intellect will be telling, nitya nitya vastu viveka, when it becomes very strong in the mind, everything it will test, is it nitya? Is it going to be nitya? This is long lasting, it is deep, it is lot of joy. He says no.
But it doesn't lead to the absolute Swamiji, if it continue expanding.
It does,
satyam,
yes.
Satyam jnanam ananta brahma.
Yes, yes.
If this concept, if I sit,
yes,
and the mind gets merged in intellect, then intellect in Atman, or Atman I don't say, Swamiji, but whatever the stillness,
expansion, yes,
the
yes.
Joy, expansion, and if I don't search for the content, and if it keeps on expanding,
yes.
It does not lead to akhandakara vritti, it leads,
but what happens is the heart is not brought into picture, and bliss is not brought into picture here. Existence in aspect is given more force than the bliss. The sat chit ananda, sat aspect is given more. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. Jnanam anantam. It is infinite. It is eternal. Eternity and infinity is brought into picture. Existence is brought into picture.
But along with that, vijnanam anantam brahma is also there.
Yes. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma.
Vijnanam
anantam brahma. If you combine the two.
Yes, combine the two.
Then it must go with the existence. Existence.
Water.
Independently, ananda means, again we will be giving importance to the ananda, the orientation becomes on the other side. Because of infinity, because of eternity, the ananda is projected. Actually, sat, chit, ananda. Sat and chit produce the ananda. Ananda doesn't have an existence by itself. Sat and chit must be there. It must be conscious. Consciousness must be there. Who is ananda? Sat must be there. Sat must be ha chit. Sat must be there. Existence must be there. Existence must have consciousness. And then what manifests is ananda.
So I should be giving importance to
Satya
and Chitta, not
Ananda. Yes, yes.
Should be
right. No, Ananda will flow. Ananda will flow. But you are holding and moving. It is like air and earth. Where on what you are moving, what you are experiencing. Air you are experiencing, earth you are holding. You are walking on the earth. We can't say you are not experiencing the earth. You are experiencing earth. Holding is most important. Experiencing is not important. Experiencing is ananda. Breeze you are enjoying, but you are walking. If you stop walking, breeze will stop. your vehicle is running because of that air is coming.
So here japa comes into picture, Swamiji. I should be holding on to japa.
Japa will remain at all times, almost.
Hey, how to penetrate, Swamiji, from here?
Into the...
How to search for the content. Swamiji said we have to search for the content. Then comes omkara. Anahata, anahata shabda. So how to penetrate from this state? How to go ahead? When the heart or ego wants to get expand in the expansion, how to once again bring back and penetrate, concentrate and penetrate?
Yes, what we do is the penetration takes into expansion itself, means I project myself like a light ray passing through the glass. A glass wall is there, thick glass wall. How does the light go? Every part it goes, it projects. I go like that in the, I project myself because I am penetratable. That is like a glass and I am like light. I can pass into it. That I, whole my I is going. Trying to understand a problem, my intellect alone is going, I am staying behind. Like that I don't penetrate my mind or intellect alone. No. I go. Like light going through the, this one, I go through the stillness and then I will understand what is inside. The stillness and silence, the content of the silence is known by my expansion into it. So, you are expanding, you are entering into deeper and deeper layers. Suppose ocean, as you are penetrating into, suppose you are sunlight entering into ocean, the deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper you are going, miles and miles you are going inside. And what all pervaded area is also covered with this, your own light. You are one with that. You are penetrating deeper also. It's a beautiful thing. When it practically actually happens, it is a entirely different. You will clearly, just like you can hear the sound, just like you can see the sight, you can experience every bit of the, what is anahata, it is experienceable. Without ear, you will not have ear. But we call it shabda. It is not actually shabda. It is a pulsation. At every point it is a pulsation. Anahata shabda. It is a causal drive, which is continuing, causal drive.
So with the same expansion vritti, the same vritti should be used to penetrate also.
Yes, yes, yes. I have no part when I enter into the inner silence. I am whole, expanding further and further. It needs a little imagination. And then, I must become that. Simulation, first it begins with imagination, then it enters into visualization, then it enters into simulation, then it enters into actuality. Actuality. When the time is there, by grace of God, all things aside, let the body mind make something, attend to the things, but in the consciousness, God conscious, Krishna conscious, Ramakrishna conscious, God consciousness, Chaitanya consciousness, awareness, these things must totally occupy. Every bit, whatever happens, oh, this is passing. Passing event. This is passing, this is passing. From childhood we have seen nothing remained. Nothing remained. This also will not remain. It will go away. But God has made all arrangements. Skip it. You have to make the way. Then, what else? Any other question? Sandeep, uncle and all?
This
Kandanata.
Oh, oh, oh.
intellect, mind, then even my karana sharira.
Yes.
Even my karana sharira in Ishvara.
Yes.
After that, what remains? What remains?
No.
Expansion alone.
No, cosmic level, cosmic existence remains.
Cosmic existence remains, no, Swamiji. Then, if that is the way, what should be the vritti there? Even after merging our cosmic karana sharira.
Then I am one with the Ishvara, I am one with the whole universe. You will not find difference. Jiva Jagat Ishvara dissolves.
The Triputi goes off,
No, Triputi will remain. The seer, seen and experiencer, experienced and experience will remain. Triputi will remain. The three entities, Jiva Jagat Ishvara, will dissolve into one cosmic whole. Part was looking at the remaining part. Now part is put back, whole it becomes. The moment it becomes whole, there is a one homogeneous existence. The Jiva Jagat Ishvara disappears.
Then there akhandakara vritti comes from where, Swamiji?
Because I am experiencing I am the universe and experiencing myself floating in the absolute. Whole universe I am, and I have distinction but no difference. Wave and ocean. I am wave and ocean. I am finding that oneness, but still I am finding its tripudi is there. I am one with the universe, I am telling. I am one with the God. I am one with the absolute, I am telling. I am experiencing oneness with the absolute. Experiencer is there. Now this is the akhandakara vritti.
So there also we have to penetrate for the anahata dvani?
No. Anahata dvani stands far behind.
Because this is the way Swamiji had told sthula sukshma karana.
Yes.
Merging sthula existence into virata. Sukshma into
Hiranyagarbha,
Karana Sharira into Ishvara.
Ishvara.
After these three...
Immediately you signed one homogeneous existence.
Yes, Swamiji.
The creation is already in the first step of divinity alone is there.
Yes, Swamiji.
The causal has... The absolute has ended. The Bindu...
Ishvara.
Bindu has become the Aparanada, and Aparanada is just about to become the space.
Yes.
Yeah. Only divinity is there now. First layer is divinity. Satyam Shivam Sundaram.
Yes, Swamiji.
You are in the Satyam Shivam Sundaram state.
Now,
you are experiencing that oneness with the means. You are a wave and the Sachidananda Sagara is there. you are a wave, you are experiencing the Sachidananda Sagara. There, when you are grown to the moment you grow to the cosmic level, you become one with it, one with the absolute also. It is just like ice floating in water. I am not different from water, but I am distinct from water. Ice is distinct from water, but not different from water. Like that, I am assuming my infinite existence of universe. But I am a wave which is one with the ocean. But I am aware of the being wave.
Yes.
I have no contents. This will slow. This is Akhandakaravrati comes to destroy all the last. Yes, the experiencer dissolves. When the experience is dissolving, the last stage is called Akhandakaravrati.
Yes,
now he is experiencing total oneness with the as Ishvara, as the universe, as the cosmic existence. He has become the cosmic existence and experiencing total oneness with the absolute. The experiencer is still there. It is dissolving away. The experiencer is dissolving away. The total oneness it is experiencing. The dissolving state is called the Akhandakara Vritti. That Akhandakara Vritti comes only to dissolve that experiencer.
Is this a
Nirvikalpa
Samadhi, Swamiji?
Yes. It is.
But any individual soul can attain this state?
Yes, oh, yes. Oh, yes.
All the karma or whatever.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes.
By practice and mumukshatva.
Yes,
and
yes.
Sincere.
Yes.
Longing.
Yes. The thing is, we should not keep anything inside. That emptiness of inside is most important part in any of these sadhanas, Akhandakaravrati sadhana. We keep so many things inside. Carry. Like a bus we are carrying. That emptiness must be experienced. Every moment you must be experienced. You must be able to call and tell Thakur. Thakur, you see inside, nothing is there inside. Nobody is there. Come. That emptiness, total emptiness, we have to experience at all times. Then it is possible. Otherwise, with this, you cannot enter. With anybody, anything of this world, you cannot enter. It's a quantum jump. You have to leave everything. Now, when it is empty, it is easy to expand. We don't expand because of the inner weightage. Binding, it's binding to the world. Ragadveshas are binding.
No, Swamiji, more than Ragadvesha, it is fear, Swamiji. Fear of losing the existence of the body.
Clinging to life.
Is there clinging to life? Yes, Swamiji, it is clinging to life.
That's why, from the beginning, the Adhara is given, God alone can give. And this bodily existence is just to transcend the nature and go. There is eternal existence, independent. I am not body, I am not body. I am the self behind. My existence independent of body must be always, four awarenesses must be always there. My existence independent of body, then Jiva, Jagat, to see divine everywhere, Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, to feel the living presence of God at all times and intimately love and offer all the activities to God as an oblation into the Absolute. These four awarenesses will make the abhinivesha to easily, you can peel it off when the time comes.
Very difficult, Swami, the abhinivesha to cross over.
Yes.
But
equally difficult is to make inner stuff empty. Once the inner...
So, Swami, in bliss we forget everything, Swami. Even inner, nothing I remember in bliss or in expansion. But this clinging to life is not going, Swami. suddenly, oh, I'm losing myself. This how to get rid of, I don't understand.
Again and again, the first one, my existence independent of body. I must shift my existence from bodily existence to spiritual. This body, in Buddhism, every day he has to feel the, this is the last day. Next day won't be there. Facing death, it is a beautiful state. I am going to leave this body and go. What a joy it is. All problems are because of this bodily existence. Now, when the body I am going to leave, even sleeping, temporary separation from the body, everybody likes that sleeping so much because it separates from the body. They want to forget the body, be away from the body. And we are going to be that awareness, where I am going, what am I, again and again. The Guru goes on insisting, main instruction in the Gurukula is to live independent of body, to live independent of body. Now,
body is a security, Swamiji.
Yes. Now, I don't know where I exist, actually. My bodily existence doesn't limit me. I clearly see body is just I am carrying like a pillowcase somewhere I am carrying. That emptiness I feel inside. And one awareness of my existence, all renouncing sannyasin, a picture of this one is in my consciousness. Nothing holding on in this world, nothing seeking, God alone. That one. That picture, that emptiness, awareness of the absolute existence, God, all this make the, what if the body goes, before the body goes off, we have to leave the body and sit inside. This one has to come. First thing is, what is missing in us is awareness of my spiritual existence. The Chaitanya, one simple one, glimpse is sufficient. You need not see also properly. A glimpse that comes. If we can enter the Vijnanamaya Kosha and experience directly the Chaitanya, it is a wonder. In a spiritual awakening, if it takes place. Otherwise, a glimpse of it is sufficient to separate you from the body. Afterwards, you'll be sitting in the body like sitting in a car. It's
the second akara vritti also gets you the same experience,
no, Swamiji? Yes. Akanda akara vritti comes only after spiritual awakening.
But it is a different road altogether.
Yes, yes, yes.
Sukshma karana.
Yes, yes.
Just merge. And you, Karana
Sharira
also, you merge in God.
In the nature. Nature. In God. God. Ishvara, no? Ishvara, yes,
Karana,
yes.
Karana Sharira in the
Ishvara. Yes, yes.
Then afterwards, only Parabrahma Tattva.
Yes.
In that, we try to experience oneness with the Parabrahma Tattva.
Yes, yes.
There you experience the same spirit, no, Swamiji.
Yes.
So there, why Vijnanamaya Kosha or spiritual awakening is not required there?
No.
It's a different road.
Yes. First, dissolving my individual physical existence into the cosmic existence itself is a big achievement. Big achievement.
But how do we know? Swamiji, we practice this every day. But how do we know that whether what is happening? It just remains as an imagination, or actually whether it is happening
the
sukshma karana.
The moment the physical bodily existence become one with the cosmic existence, you expand to the cosmic level to know and understand everything at the physical level. Everything.
Okay.
stars, this, that, everything you pervade. Unseen things which we do not even know, you pervade. Just like you know, you are pervading this body, every part of this body, ear, eyes, everything. Like that.
You mean to say, we will know that everything about stars, planets, everything we will know.
You pervade. Anything happening, you will know. It's happening. Now, suppose, do you know how your kidney is working? No. But you are pervading it. Anybody touches or anything, pain comes, immediately you will know. Because you are pervading it. It is like light passing in space. When light is passing in space, it doesn't illumine the space. If object comes in between only, it will illumine. If object is...
Here I am offering and going to the next stage.
Yes, you are pervading the universe, but anywhere anything happening only you will understand.
But we are not, our mind is not going there, Swamiji. Sthula Shariram, Viradam Shah, Antarmanishita Sarvam, Vyapya Narayana Sthita.
Yes, yes.
Atma Me Shujyantam, Jyotiraham Viraja Vipapaso. This is God, not me. Like that I am transcending this body and going to the next stage.
Yes.
Like that even Hiranyagarbhastu Sukshma Shariram Hiranyagarbham Shah, Antarmanishita Sarvam, Vyapya Narayana Sthita.
Yes.
So here the importance is given to Narayana, not for myself.
Yes.
So I am searching for my existence. After that is Karana Sharira, Ishwaramshaha, Antarbhanishata Sarva, Vyapi Narayana Sthitaha, Paramatma Me Shudyanta, Jyoti Raham Viraja Vipakma. So I am searching for this Jyoti. I am not bothered about what Stula Sukshma Karana.
Yes, yes.
Whether I am pervading or, because it is Narayana himself.
Yes.
So here I am searching for the Jyoti. Who am I? So I am searching for, I am aiming at the Parabrahma Tattva, Swamiji.
Yes.
So if that is the case, how I will know that where am I standing? If this is the daily in and out, this is what I am practicing. How I will know that where am I standing?
Just like when you enter into deep sleep, when you enter into dream state, you will not know you are entering into dream state.
Mm-mm.
Waking state, when you comes, you know you have come to the waking state. You will not have doubt that I am awake or not.
Mm-mm.
Like that, when you expand to the cosmic level, you will know more lively, you will know more clearly, you know, than what you can imagine. Your expansion.
I'm not giving importance to whether I am aware or I am, because I want to transcend. So I want to say this is Narayana, not me.
Yes.
So my aim is something else, Swami.
Yes. Our aim is independent of the state. Now, I have to come to the waking state, but my aim is not to come to the waking state. I want to enjoy, I want to work, I want to do something in the waking state. If I can do without waking state also, is all right. But without coming to waking state, I cannot do. I have to come to the waking state to do anything, whether it is cooking or...
How I will have offered
Stula Seshadira
to
go to the cosmic level, expand to the cosmic level and go beyond to the objective ultimate. I have to expand to the cosmic level and then objective ultimate. Or I must go inward to the innermost door and expand inwardly and go to the subjective ultimate. The subjective ultimate and objective ultimate are same. I have to go. Now, in sleep and waking up, I expand a little, come to my waking state, I do my work, earning, eating, cooking, and again I shrink back, go to the point, enter the cosmic Chaitanya, again come back. I take a dip in the cosmic Chaitanya, come back. Again from point, I expand only this much. Can I expand little more? To Prakriti level I can expand. I can expand. I am expanding only up to my body. And bringing to awareness a few things of my life. Now, can I expand to the cosmic level? This expansion to the cosmic level is next one step before the. This is actually what they do is they expand to this level and draw back how the creation came. The whole thing is reduced to the Prithivi Tattva. Prithivi Tattva is merged in the Jala Tattva. Jala Tattva is merged in the Agni Tattva. Agni Tattva in the Vayu Tattva. Vayu Tattva in the Akasha Tattva. Then with the in Advaitic superimposition and de-superimposition.
So with this puja method, stula sukshma karana sharira, shuddhyam tam jyotirham virajya vipapma
bhuyate. Yes.
That is the way we are going.
No.
Where it leads us?
No, we are not there, we are not going in this path. There it is a bhakti school we are utilizing to make myself totally a spiritual entity, to love the spiritual entity. I want to become divine, to love the divine. So, I am removing all the things which I am not. Jyotirham, I am insisting. I am eliminating all other things with which I have identified. I want to become a pure divine being, to love the divine. There it is different. Here it is different. I am offering myself into the cosmic. I am expanding my consciousness. I have come to the bodily level. I growed maximum to the world level. And maximum corona, this, that, my consciousness. What is happening in America, this, that. That's all maximum consciousness. I don't expand it to the cosmic level. To practically expand. Actual expansion is only up to the bodily level now. Other things are observations and calculations, inference. But I am expanding. Immediately I start moving about, I start experiencing. Now I have to expand to the cosmic level to experience the absolute. Inward also, I have to leave one by one layers and dive within to the core to enter into the transcendental again. I have to transcend the nature on this side or that side. Internal nature I can transcend and go, or external nature I can transcend and go. Entering into the absolute is akhandakara vritti. Appa. Jai Ram Krishna. Shall we end? We see that every moment of time is utilized fully in the divine awareness, empty inside. Om Niranjanam Nityam Anantarupam Bhaktanukampa Drita Vigraham Vai Ishavataram Paramesha Medium Tam Ramakrishna Shirasa Namama.